Hello, Jose from Exalate Integration Tool here. Next, I am going to show you how you can integrate ServiceNow incidents, request items, and any of the ServiceNow entities with Azure DevOps work items so that you can collaborate between these two products live. It doesn't matter if it's within the same company or through multiple companies. Exalate has a distributed architecture that allows you to agree with what you integrate with the other side. So for security purposes, this is a really good tool if you have multiple companies. As I mentioned, I am going to use Exalate specifically for the integration, and I'm going to show you how you get it, how you start a connection, and I'm going to show you a sync back and forth. You're going to see how fast and easy it is to start a basic sync scenario, where you can synchronize title, description, comments, attachments. All that can be done in a couple of minutes. And then afterwards, you can synchronize specific custom fields or any type of field from any of the two entities or the two sides with some script that you'll see next. So how do you get Exalate? For the Azure DevOps side, you go to the Visual Studio Marketplace and you look for Exalate, you'll find us there. For the ServiceNow side, you'll have to go to our Exalate.com site, and then there you will have the option to click on integrations at the top, and then you will see each of the products we support. I'm going to open that site so you see how that's done. You go, so I'm in Exalate.com. You go to integrations. You click on, you can also click on Azure DevOps here, and it jumps to the Visual Studio Marketplace posting. And then that's where you would get it for this side. And then for the ServiceNow side, you can click here, you fill this form, we approve it, and then you receive your Exalate node with a URL, a specific URL, and then you can add it to your ServiceNow instance. After you have done that, you'll be able to create a connection between the two products, and you will be able to start a sync. So I already did this in each of these products, so I already have it installed and configured. I gave it permission. This shouldn't take more than a couple of minutes. For the Azure DevOps side, you will need to give it a personal access token that is valid for whatever time you set up. Usually I add it for a year, and then after a year you just create a new access token for Exalate to work in your Azure DevOps. So I already did that, and now I am going to go to the Exalate console in each of these products. As I mentioned before, Exalate has a separate console for each of the products. This gives you a distributed architecture, which has a bunch of pros and positive aspects if you want to collaborate with other companies that where you don't want a centralized UI, because you don't want to have one of the sites have full power over the synchronization. In this case, each of the sites has control over the synchronization. You'll see what I'm talking about next. So I'm going to go to organization settings in the Azure DevOps side. And this is, I click here. I'm going to move my head. And then if I scroll down, I click on, Exalate. Click on Exalate and Exalate should load. Meanwhile, I'm also going to look for Exalate in the ServiceNow side. So here, after I have downloaded and configured it, I can look for Exalate. And here I'm going to click on Exalate console, and this will open the Exalate UI for ServiceNow. As you see here, I am already in the Exalate UI, and I have some buttons here. Each of them has a specific reason why they're there. I'll let you know each of the features of these buttons. For now, I'm going to show you the connections button, which is the one that I mostly work with when I'm creating a connection and doing a basic sync. So in the connections button, I have a bunch of connections. And this the reason behind this is because with an Exalate node, you can synchronize to any of the products we support. And you can have unlimited connections and unlimited syncs. So as you might see here, some of these connections go not only to ServiceNow, but go to Jira or Zendesk or GitHub or any of the products we support. All this is happening at the same time. For now, I am going to deactivate some of the connections just in case they are related to this connection that I am going to create, so that there's no double connection with the same product. And now I am going to initiate a connection. This can be initiated from Azure DevOps or ServiceNow. It doesn't matter which side you create the connection from. As you see here on the ServiceNow side, I also have a bunch of connections that I can also deactivate. So now I am going to initiate the connection from the Azure DevOps site. And I have two options, either a public destination type or private. So in this case, both of the products are public facing to the internet. So in that case, I'll choose this option. But if I was connecting this Azure DevOps to a Jira server behind a firewall, I would choose this option so that instead of pushing the updates bi-directionally, it will be through a polling method. So every 30 seconds, the Jira server behind a firewall will check if there are any updates on the other side. Since both are public, I'm going to choose public, and it will be through a pushing method. I'm going to click next, and now here I am going to copy the URL of the ServiceNow site and paste it here. I am going to click, I am going to fill the connection information. This is just naming for this connection. So it's going to be Azure Test, ServiceNow Test, connection for video. I click next, and now I am going to select the project from Azure DevOps that I want to start the synchronization from. In this case, it's going to be testing. That's my project name in Azure DevOps. I click initiate, and this generates an invitation code, which now I can copy it, and now I'll have to send it to my ServiceNow people. Since I have full control here, I just go to ServiceNow. I accept the invitation on the top and paste the invitation code. It will be this long string that you just paste. Click next. And now confirm. And now I can start configuring the sync. The same from the other side. Okay, here, edit connection. So as you see here, I have four panels in total. I can, each of the sites has an outgoing sync and an incoming sync. The outgoing sync is the information that you're sending. So all this information is being sent from Azure DevOps. If you see the details in each line, it will be the work item key, the assignee, the summary, the type, status, labels, and all this information. And if you go to the ServiceNow side, outgoing sync, you can see that it is six fields related to, for now, the incident section. So I'm sending the incident key, short description, attachments, comments, and state. So this is the information that's being sent from both sides. However, they don't have to land in the same field in the other side. I can just, from the information that comes from the other side, so imagine I only work in Azure DevOps, I can set a specific custom field for that information to land. So if I want to see the incident state in a custom field in Azure DevOps, I would click here. If I know the custom field name, I would just go here, work item, custom field, example, equals replica.state. And I would paste it here. So what's happening here is that the status from ServiceNow is landing in a custom field in the work item of Azure DevOps. I can obviously also sync it with the work item status. That is the most common scenario, but I just wanted to show you that it doesn't only have to be that way. Now I am going to create a trigger so you see the sync in progress and like working. So the trigger is what will start the sync. And this can be either from the Azure DevOps side or the ServiceNow side. For now, I am going to start it from the ServiceNow side. So I'm going to click on triggers, create a trigger. Select the entity type. These are some of the entities we support. There are more. We support custom tables too. I'm going to click on incident. And I am now here, I am going to add any ServiceNow query that you would like to start the trigger from. So I'm going to keep it simple and add urgency equals one, but this can be urgency equals one and assignee equals X. Obviously this will need to be with the ServiceNow query language, which in case you didn't know, you can click here. You can go to incidents, for example. And this would be a query that if you right-click on it, you can click copy query, and this is where you would paste it. So you just go here and you paste it. And this is the lingo of the query. I'm going to keep it simple and just set a query that is urgency equals one. And what will happen is that if I create an incident where urgency equals one, that will start the sync. If that event does not happen when I create the incident, there won't be any issue creation or work item creation in the Azure DevOps side. So now I'm going to click Add, Publish, and I am going to go ahead and create an incident from ServiceNow. Urgency changing to one, yeah. Now I am going to give this short description, title example, from ServiceNow, description, this is a description test, and now I am going to submit this incident. If I copy this incident number and I go to the Exalate panel and I click on entity sync status and I paste it here, I can see the status of the synchronization. It says it is waiting for remote, and what this means is that it's already in the work in the Azure DevOps side. It's being processed. It says it is already synchronized, so now if I have ServiceNow Azure DevOps credential, which I have, I can click on this link and it will jump to the Azure DevOps work item. As you see here, I have the title from the incident. It's the same title example from ServiceNow. Here it is, and then the description. This is a description test. And now if I comment from the Azure DevOps side, I am going to save it. As you see on the lower right section of the work item, we can see the status of the synchronization. It changed from synchronized to waiting for remote because I just did an update in the comment section. And as you see here, it's already in the incident side. So comment from Azure DevOps is here. And now if I comment from the ServiceNow side, comment from Snow, it will also go to the Azure DevOps side. Now let's refresh this. Oh, I didn't update the ServiceNow side. That's why it's not coming up. Now that I update it, it should come up. Yeah, there it is. Comment from ServiceNow. So this is, as I mentioned, it has been 17 minutes and I started the connection like 5 minutes after I started talking. So it's like in 12 minutes, I already created a connection and synced back and forth these specific fields, title, description, and comments. I can also send an attachment out of the box. And this is something that you can also do when you start creating a connection. You can do a lot more things with the script rules. You can synchronize any custom field. We have a ton of documentation on how to do that. I can drop the link below in the description of the video. But if this is something that interests you, you can go to exalate.com. We have documentation there. We also have demos in case you want to see the product again with one of our engineers. Hope this was useful. You can start this test with a 30-day trial if needed. With any of the products that we support, which, as I mentioned before, is not only Azure DevOps and ServiceNow, it's also GitHub, Zendesk, Jira, any of the Jiras like Jira Cloud, Jira Server, Data Center, and within those Jiras, Service Management, Core, or Jira Software. So I hope this video helped you in knowing how you can integrate these two products through Exalate, and looking forward to hear from you if you are interested to learn more. Have a great day. Bye-bye.